When working to reverse insulin resistance, it can be difficult to tell if you're moving in the right direction. Of course, if the scale's going down, this can be an indicator of progress. However, not everyone who's insulin resistant is overweight. And beyond that, weight loss isn't always immediate. So what are some other signs that insulin resistance is reversing? I'm gonna give you 6 to watch out for. And as we go through this video, let me know in the comment section down below if you've experienced them. Number 6, fewer sugar cravings. Feeling hungry after you eat, and specifically having cravings for sugar, is a very common symptom of insulin resistance. This is because when you're insulin resistant, your body is not able to use energy efficiently. You might be eating, and the glucose or energy is there, but your cells aren't able to use it. As far as they are concerned, you need more energy. You need to eat more. And that's when you're going to experience cravings. But when this hunger and these cravings start to fade away, that is a good indicator that your insulin resistance is reversing. Number 5, your waist is shrinking. The type of fat we store around our waist is called visceral fat. This fat is hard to the touch and it surrounds our organs. And visceral fat is directly associated with insulin resistance, which is why measuring your waist circumference is a really strong indicator of your resistance or sensitivity. When you're insulin resistant, fat gets stored in places that it typically wouldn't, including around your abdomen. And this type of fat can be very stubborn to lose. Really, the only way to do it is by improving your insulin sensitivity. So if you're measuring your waist and it's starting to get slimmer, this is a good sign that you're headed in the right direction. Number 4, triglycerides decreasing. This is one of the first signs that your insulin resistance is reversing. As soon as you start to make the correct diet and lifestyle changes, your triglycerides are going to decrease very quickly. Number 3, HDL increasing. And the second half to your triglycerides decreasing is your HDL increasing. HDL is the protective type of cholesterol. You want it to be higher in relation to your triglycerides. And the ratio between triglycerides and HDL is actually another really strong indicator of insulin resistance. This ratio decreasing is a good thing. Number 2, increased testosterone. This one is for men only. Insulin resistance can cause testosterone to decrease in men. And as your insulin resistance begins to improve, your testosterone will increase as well. And this is actually the opposite for women, which we'll talk about in just a moment when we get to the final sign that insulin resistance is reversing. But for men, if you have low testosterone and you see it starting to increase, this is a good indicator you're headed in the right direction. And finally, number 1, which is for women only, your menstrual cycle is becoming more regular. As I just touched on, insulin resistance impacts women's hormones differently than it impacts men's. It actually increases testosterone for women. Of course, for men, having higher testosterone is a good thing, but for women, well, we do need some testosterone, you don't want it to be too high. And here's how this all ties in with your menstrual cycle. When we are insulin resistant, our insulin levels are high, and high levels of insulin actually stop the body from converting testosterone to estrogen when it should be. And of course, this leaves you with high testosterone. Now, in a healthy cycle, there's an increase in estrogen around day 14, and this increase triggers ovulation. So if there's no increase in estrogen, there's no ovulation. And no ovulation means your period is gonna be irregular. As insulin resistance improves, your insulin levels will lower and your other hormones will balance, leading to a menstrual cycle that's more regular. Now, all of these signs are great and strong indicators that you're headed in the right direction with your insulin resistance, but if you really want to know for sure, you have to have your fasting insulin tested. You can ask your doctor to do this, they will draw blood and they can test your fasting insulin, and they can use this number to find your HOMA IR score. Or you can also use an at-home testing kit like the one from So Well Health. Their weight biology kit tests 8 key biomarkers for metabolic health, including fasting insulin and your HOMA IR. And it also tests your triglyceride and HDL as well, which we spoke about earlier. Once you receive the kit and you provide a blood sample, you mail it back and your results are going to be physician reviewed. Within the next 2 to 5 days, you're going to receive a full online report with next steps you can take. I'm going to put the link to check it out in the description box down below, and you can use code KATE10 to save 10% off the kit. It's currently only available in the United States. Anyways, guys, that's all I have for you today. Let me know in the comment section down below if you have seen any of these improvements. I love chatting with you guys there. And yeah, that's all I have for you. I will see you next time. Bye.